Dear King's College London Medical School study on dongs. Great science. Just want to say right off the bat, you're doing God's work by really getting down and dirty with all those dongs. I mean, nobody wants to, but someone has to. And thankfully for all of us, you already have. However, I do have to say that I felt your study was lacking a certain je ne sais quoi. I mean, it's great to know that the average flaccid dong is 3.61 inches and the average erect dong is 5.17 inches. Really, that's all great stuff to know. But like, isn't it kind of superficial? Aren't we reducing the dongs to just their size? As a fan of dongs myself, I know that there's just so much more to them. Every dong is unique and beautiful in its own dong way. And I did read that all of you scientists stretched out the flaccid dongs, and I'm not overlooking that kind of dedication to research, but I guess my point is that there's a lot more to dongs than just their length. In fact, as a woman, that often isn't even the first thing I notice when I meet a new dong, because I look for personality. I mean, we all know that coochies are beautiful, mysterious flowers, so let's not make dongs out to be meat sticks. Instead, they are elegant, sloping vectors of pleasure. Or whatever. Anyway, keep up the science, and remember, every dong is different, and size isn't everything. Love, Sheena.